Welcome to this training on the System Performance Map component of the Stella Performance Module, or Stella P. In this video, we will provide you with a high-level understanding of how to use the System Performance Map to see how people flow through your homeless system of care. Before we look at Stella P and the System Performance Map interface, I want to quickly introduce the idea of a service pathway. A service pathway is the combination of services that a household uses before they exit the homeless service system and, ideally, enter permanent housing. Service pathways are helpful to show you the combination of interventions that people use within your homeless response system and how effective those combinations are at resolving their homelessness. All communities are assessing households in coordinated entry and making determinations about the housing and services that would best meet their needs. Evaluating system use within the structure of a service pathway will help your community to understand how to more effectively serve different types of households with differing characteristics. Now we will look at the System Performance Map interface, which is one of the tabs under the main dashboard. You can find it here. The System Map interface provides a unique way for you to visualize the various service pathways in your homeless system of care and understand how the households that enter your system within a given period of time move through it. Specifically, it shows you the percent of households served in each of the project types within the homeless system, how people move between these project types, which is the service pathway, the percent who exited each service pathway to permanent destinations, and the percent of those who exited to permanent destinations who returned to homelessness within 6 months of their exit. We will also explain some of the different ways you can use this system map, including how to break down the map and focus on various elements of your system, such as by population or service pathway. First, let's take a look at the overall system map. As you can see, at the top of the System Performance Map page, you can see two drop-down menus. The first looks at household category, and the second looks at service pathways. The default selections are all households in all pathways, which provides you with a whole system view. Looking at this map of your full system, you are able to see every type of intervention, what percentage of households move through each service type, and how the households in your system move towards permanent housing. For example, some households may have a stay in emergency shelter, then move directly to rapid rehousing. Others may move from an emergency shelter project into a permanent supportive housing project. As I mentioned earlier, the sequence of movement through these available interventions is called a service pathway. This map shows all the service pathways, or the flow of how all household types move through the various interventions within your homeless system. You will note that the box for each service type includes a figure for the total number of households served by that intervention. Those figures will include both those households that were just served by that intervention, as well as those who were served by that project as part of another pathway. The boxes also include data on the average number of days households stayed in that project type. In addition to showing you how long the average household stayed in each individual project type, at the top of the system map diagram, you can see the average length of time that households were homeless in your system during the year. Now let's take a closer look at this overall system map. You can see that a total of 3,918 households entered or were served by the system of care during the reporting period. The branches you see here show the different service pathways in the system of care. For example, here we see that 88% of households initially entered emergency shelter or safe havens upon entry to the system. From there, you can see that 5% of households who initially entered emergency shelter or safe havens moved to a transitional housing project. Additionally, 7% moved from emergency shelter or safe havens to rapid rehousing, and 3% moved to permanent supportive housing. As you can see here, 85% of households were only served by emergency shelter or safe havens, 14% of whom ultimately exited to permanent housing. I want to point out a few aspects of this overall system map that can be helpful in visualizing when people are being housed in your system. First, let's look at the point of housing line that we see here on the map. This gray dotted line indicates the point at which people are counted as housed within the system. So, as you can see, all of the households to the left of the line, those in emergency shelter or safe haven or transitional housing projects, are considered homeless, while those to the right of the line are considered housed. You'll notice the boxes for rapid rehousing and permanent supportive housing are bisected by the housing line. To the left of the line, it shows the average number of days it took for a household to be housed after they were enrolled in the intervention. And to the right, the average number of days that households were housed in that project type after their move-in date. You will also see at the far right of the system map that there is a total number of permanent exits for that year. In this case, 778 households had a permanent exit from the homeless system of care. You can see that the various service pathways feed into that total figure with green arrows from each. For example, 353 households permanently exited the system from the emergency shelter safe haven only pathway, and 275 households exited from the various rapid rehousing pathways. In addition to seeing the total number of permanent exits from the system, you are able to see how many of those households actually ended up returning to the homeless system within 6 months of exit. This red line shows that 14% of households that exited the system ended up returning to homelessness, taking an average of 126 days to return, as determined by subsequent contact with the CoC's homeless services. I do want to point out that there are a few limitations to the system's return data included in this system map. First, because these figures are based on HMIS data, it will only reflect those people who are identified as returning to homelessness by an HMIS contributing provider. If a household returns to the street or is served by a non-HMIS contributing provider, they will likely not be included. Additionally, this map shows only those households who return to homelessness within 6 months of being housed. Keep in mind, then, this really only includes data for those people who exited to permanent housing within the first 6 months of the year. If you want to look more closely at your system return numbers, we recommend that you go to the returns page in Stella P, which you can find here. While looking at your overall system map can give you a great sense of how people were served in each project type and the outcomes for each, if you really want to see how various service pathways are performing, you need to focus in on that pathway. As I mentioned earlier, this system map has the functionality to filter by service pathway. For example, you can look at those households who were only served by either emergency shelter or safe havens. To do this, you would go up to the drop-down menu and select ESSH only. Now, in addition to narrowing down the view on the map to the emergency shelter safe haven pathway, you may notice that the data points look a little different than when we looked at the system map as a whole. Here, it says that 75% of households were served by emergency shelter or safe havens. If you remember, when we looked closely at the flow into ESSH in the larger system map, that showed 88% of households initially entered ESSH. Remember that this narrower view is looking at those households that receive services from only ESSH programs. It removes households that moved on to other project types, such as transitional housing, rapid rehousing, or permanent supportive housing. This box also shows you that the average length of stay for households in this pathway was 44 days. From here, you can see that 14% of households that exited this pathway exited into permanent destinations. Of those with permanent exits, 19% returned to homelessness after they exited. You can take this detailed view for every service pathway in your community. For example, if you are interested in the outcomes of those households in the emergency shelter to rapid rehousing pathway, you can select that from the drop-down menu. There is a specific flowchart for every service pathway in your system, complete with average number of days homeless, number of permanent exits, and rates of returns to homelessness. Similarly, you can narrow your focus by household type. For example, if you want to look at how adult-only households move through your entire system, you can reset the service pathway drop-down to all pathways, and then move to the population type drop-down and select adult-only households. This will show the larger service map that we saw earlier, but with only data from those households made up solely of adults. You'll see here that the map looks the same, but the data points have changed. 3,282 total adult-only households were served in the homeless system, as compared to 3,918 total households when we looked at all population types. You can see that all of the data points are adjusted to reflect how these 3,282 households moved through the system, as well as updating the average days that adult-only households were served by your homeless system of care. From the dropdown, you have numerous options of different populations you can select if you want to look more closely at how certain population types move through your system. The system app also has the capability of allowing you to narrow even further. You have the option of looking at how different populations move through various service paths. To do so, you can select one household type and one service pathway. For example, perhaps you're interested in how families are moving through emergency shelter safe havens to rapid rehousing. First, we can select our household type of adult and child. And then we can select the ESSH plus RRH option from the pathway dropdown. Now you only see the data related to how that population moved through the system. You will see that 22% of families entered this service pathway. They spent an average of 81 days in emergency shelter or safe havens. You can see here that these households had an average pre-move-in wait of 44 days and spent an average of 183 days in rapid rehousing. 90% of these families exited the homeless system of care to permanent housing, of which 0% returned to homelessness. I hope this overview of the System Performance Map interface has been informative and helped you understand one of the ways Stella P can increase your understanding of how households flow through your homeless system of care.